Beloved, we welcome you to another exciting day on the Voice of Resurrection devotional. Make sure you go to Bible study tonight. If you guys have Bible study like us on Wednesday night, some of you had it last night, some of you have it tomorrow night on Thursday. Study God's Word. Keep yourself in the Word and in the flow of the Holy Spirit. God will do exciting things as we repent. I'm telling you, beloved, He's so eager. God is so eager to bless us and to use us in this time. Don't mind the attacks of the enemy. Wow, since we've been out there ministering and defending the gospel on television, there are all kinds of things happening, but don't be moved by these things. That's all part of the equation. God will use us so mightily. Satan has there's nothing he can do because God is sending you to do what you are doing. Yes, don't mind all the attacks. You will get it done in Jesus' name. Amen. That's a word for you. I want to run quickly to Acts chapter 2, verse 38, and I'll get back to 2 Chronicles. Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promise is unto you and to your children and to all that are far off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. And with many other words did he testify and exhort, saying, save yourselves from this untoward generation. That is why I chose the text. There is a generation that has arisen that have rejected the scriptures. And every move in society all across the world is to dethrone the authority of the scriptures. And I can't handle, particularly, people that look like me, that where heritage came out of God, that will stand up publicly to defy the word of God. Who art thou? Oh, man. Oh, beloved, I'm telling you, things will happen in this city where I live soon. In Jesus' name, as we keep returning to the Lord and decreeing the glory, and the glory will rule. There's no way sons of God can be in the land and evil will conquer. It will not happen. Glory to God. Peter said, save yourself from this untoward generation. How do I save myself? Through repentance. How do I save myself? By turning back, because repentance is not saying I'm sorry and then continue to do the same thing. Repentance is saying I'm sorry and I turn around to serve the Lord. Watch this. He says, for the remission of sins. Why are we repenting? So God will remove our sins. God will remove the curses, the fruit of our sins and disobedience. And then he will send the Holy Ghost afresh. The gift of the Holy Spirit will come with power. Will come with strength, will come with glory once again. Hallelujah. And this promise is not just to me, but to my children and to all that are far off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. Do you hear the word of the Lord? You see, beloved, and that's how we will save ourselves from what's going on, by taking a stand. That's why God said to me, when the history, the annals of Georgia will be written in his presence, that I will be remembered. This church called Resurrection House for All Nations will be remembered. Remembered that we stood up for him publicly, and we are getting ready to do even greater exploits as he gives us direction and revelation. I'm asking you out there today, do you want this land where you live to be healed? Whether you live in America or in Nigeria or in England or in Russia or in Europe, in Kenya, wherever you are watching this devotional, do you want your land to be healed? Do you want to see the angel of the Lord stand up against these Muslims that are killing Christians and beheading them? Then we must embrace repentance. We must embrace repentance and move God in prayer that he will awaken as a man awaken out of wine, the Bible says. And he will shout, how he will declare his own glory, and he will come to judge the heathen. I would like to see God do to all these people what he did to the Assyrians in the Bible. One angel took care of 180-something thousand soldiers. Isn't that exciting? May the days of Elijah come when the fire of God came down and consumed the enemies of God. We are not preaching that. You see, when we are speaking about God judging evil and bringing things down, people don't understand. It's not talking about, oh, love and mercy and forgive. We are not against the sinner. We are speaking about an evil system that have arisen up. And if we don't confront them and bring them down, before long you'll be running for your life. Before long they'll be beheading you. Before long you can't read the Bible and pray. They'll be forcing you into a false religion that is a bunch of, what do you call it, 14th century Arabian culture. Concoctions of man that has no proof. We serve the living God, beloved. I pray that the church will awaken and stop this pamby-namby preaching and positions that God doesn't authenticate. Because while we're doing all of that, they are waxing stronger and stronger. And before long, they'll be in the bathroom with your daughter. Isn't it time for you to awake and get out of your comfort zone? It's time to confront apostasy. It's time to repent, beloved. Let me go back to 2 Chronicles so you can see what God said. Verse 14 again says, if my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven. That's all we need. We're not worrying about the enemy. We don't hate anybody, but we know who is behind what's going on is Satan. We need to dethrone him by the grace of God. You see? Humble their prayer and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. Do you believe that your land can be healed? I know some people say, well, these things have been prophesied. I say, yeah, but they don't have to happen in your generation. Even Ahab, with all his wickedness, just by an act of humility before God, postponed the judgments against his house for years. Don't we see the patterns in the scripture? We don't have to live in subjugation to these devils. And I will get to Mammon later on, because that's all part of the apostasy of this generation. We are busy pursuing money and forgetting the kingdom and the assignment the Lord has given to us. God has blessed me with a few material things, but I don't see that saving anybody. All the heresies of the 80s and 90s, that they will respect us because we have goods and we have nice cars and houses. It didn't change it. It made them angrier because they don't expect us. They don't even want us to have such nice things. But beloved, nothing God has given to us materially will follow us into eternal life. No, we will leave them all here. And then we're worrying about succession and this and that and the other. Well, you're gone to glory. Go and rest. Oh, beloved, and we'll forgive their sins and we'll heal their land. And God says, now my eyes shall be opened. And my ears attended to the prayer that's made in this place, speaking about the temple specifically. We love you, beloved. I hope you can handle these hard-hitting words. But I got to tell you the things in my spirit. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.